The United States has the most billionaires of any country, with roughly 700. When the so-called billionaires' income tax was recently suggested to help support President Joe Biden's budget package, it would have compelled persons in that demographic to pay yearly taxes on assets that grew in value. So how will this new tax structure affect Elon Musk, and will it demolish the world's richest man? Stay tuned as I shed more light on that. After Tesla's share price soared in January, the Tesla and SpaceX entrepreneur was pushed to the top spot. He succeeds Amazon founder Jeff Bezos, who has held the position since 2017. Mr. Musk's electric vehicle firm Tesla has grown in value this year, reaching a market capitalization of $700 billion for the first time early this year. That makes the automaker more valuable than Toyota, Volkswagen, Hyundai, General Motors, and Ford combined. Mr. Musk reacted to the news in his trademark fashion, reacting to a Twitter user who shared it with the phrase "very weird." A previous tweet posted to the top of his page provided further context for his opinions on personal wealth. "About half of my money is meant to solve issues on Earth, and the other half to help create a self-sustaining metropolis on Mars, to secure the continuation of life in case Earth is struck by a meteor like the dinosaurs or World War III occurs and we kill ourselves," it says. So, what was the world's richest man's reaction to this new proposed billion-dollar income tax? Elon Musk, the world's richest man, took to Twitter to slam the so-called billionaire tax idea, splitting Washington along ideological lines and dominating social media debate. He feels it will only complicate his mission to transport humanity to Mars. The tax concept, which would target the 700 wealthiest Americans, was devised to fund President Joe Biden's $2 trillion Build Back Better campaign, which includes a variety of unprecedented expenditures in childcare, education, healthcare, and tackling climate change. The Democratic-led initiative is meeting heavy opposition in Congress, not just from Republicans but also from more moderate Democrats. The billionaire tax's most challenging aspect is a 23.8% tax on long-term capital gains on marketable assets. It would now be charged exclusively to billionaires who earn more than $100 million per year or have $1 billion in assets. It would be a significant rewriting of the tax system, which presently taxes assets such as stock options only when purchased or sold. The new strategy will tax billionaires' wealth on a year-to-year basis as if they were company revenue. A move of this magnitude would significantly impact tech heavyweights such as Musk, Amazon founder Jeff Bezos, and Facebook's Mark Zuckerberg. Musk has been the most outspoken of the group. He warned on Twitter that a billionaire tax would only make a minor dent in the government debt. He ominously indicated that Washington would eventually go after the common populace as well. "They eventually run out of other people's money and then come after you," he tweeted. Musk revealed what he intended to do with the funds. "My objective is to utilize the money to transport mankind to Mars and safeguard the light of awareness," he tweeted. Musk's goal is to construct a self-sufficient metropolis on Mars, with a population of 1 million people by 2050. He predicts that transporting 1 million tons of goods to Mars would be necessary to reach this aim. But other things appear to be moving well pending regulatory permission. So far, no one has been able to identify precisely how much money the Martian colonization plan would ultimately necessitate, although it necessitates a certain amount of wealth. Musk projected in 2019 that starting a Martian metropolis would cost $10 trillion. Of course, this is a staggering figure. However, if this idea is adopted, Elon Musk's hopes for SpaceX would be dashed. He may get his wish since the plan has been deleted from the White House framework. Elon Musk recently liquidated his real estate holdings to focus and pour his fortune into this project. If the billionaire tax idea is approved, it will severely limit his objective since he will have to donate more to pay taxes. But will this millionaire tax be implemented? Some tax specialists have predicted that this new taxing structure will be complicated to execute. It can't be any more complex than the present complicated method we handle taxes. Furthermore, research indicates that a wealth tax would be effective and might stimulate the economy in various ways, generating cash for critical social services. Others questioned whether this move was constitutional, because while the Constitution grants Congress the power to levy taxes, it also states that direct taxes, of which there is no clear definition, should be allocated by states in such a way that each resident pays a share equal to the state's population share. However, Senate Finance Committee Chairman Ron Wyden, who initiated the proposal, has stated that income taxes do not have to be left up to the states. He has said that the tax on billionaires is based on income, not wealth, because the concept of direct taxes is ambiguous. No one should conclude that taxing billionaires is unlawful. It will be apparent in the following months if this new tax scheme will be approved and implemented, but for the time being, Elon Musk's ambition of Mars colony remains viable. That's all for today's video. Thanks for staying tuned. See you next time!